everybody, and welcome back to another episode on Thornton Farm. So we're going to jump into the case wheel loader, because the first job of today is to clamp the pit next to us. Now, if you didn't watch yesterday's video, basically we just cut the whole of filament 3 and we've put it in here, and it just needs to be fermented. I have kept some of it in the loading wagon just there, and I'm probably going to go and give that to the pigs in a minute. We don't have any pigs yet, but we will do very soon. I'm going to buy them shortly. So yeah, first job of today, just do this. It shouldn't take very long. This is quite a heavy machine. It's currently 32% compacted. It's actually compacting very quickly. I'm just using the buck rake as well. It doesn't do anything when it's not fermented yet, but it just looks good, you know, for show. Providing you don't get it stuck on the clamp. But yeah, it must be almost done now. 76% done. And almost there. 100%. So we can now cover it over, and the fermentation process can begin. Once that is done, we can start to give our cows and our pigs the silage. As someone did quite rightly point out, I believe that the silage is only for the cows in the winter time, because obviously you do this in the summertime, ready for when they're out of the fields and put away in their shed. In the summertime, they'll be out grazing in the fields. So yeah, this makes a lot of sense. The problem is that Farming Simulator doesn't have seasons, which does make it quite difficult. Also, actually, Farming Simulator doesn't... The cows, when they're in the field, they don't actually register as feeding off the grass in the field. You actually have to physically feed them. So, yeah, there are things that can be improved. Right, so we're going to go over to the pig farm, because we need to buy some. They're very, very cheap. They're £50 each, so not too bad at all. I'll probably get, I don't know, anywhere between 25 and 50. And like I said yesterday, I don't know if they're going to appreciate this grass, but it's just something for them to be getting on with while the silage is fermenting. But their yard is just here on the right hand side. To be honest, I'm not sure whereabouts in the yard the pigs are. I have the first shed. Well, that does make it easy. The other one is for the cattle. So yeah, I don't know. We're just going to have to drive in here and see if it lets us unload some. I can't really see why it wouldn't let it. I think it will do. But it probably would be a better idea to actually buy the pigs first, because then we know exactly how much to give them. So I'm going to be pressing return quite a lot. Okay, there we go. That is 50 pigs, and 50 pigs cost £2,500, the exact same price as one cow. So that really does put that into perspective of how expensive those cows are. But yeah, happy pigs. Let's give them some feed if it will let us. Hopefully it will. Yes, it does. Good. And we've still got some left over. I think that only actually used 5%. So the next job of today is to, well, I was hoping to actually replace our water bowser, because we've got this tiny water bowser and it's not really big enough for what we need. So if we can afford it, I know we're going very close to the £10,000 mark. I try not to go below that. But if we can sort of part exchange kind of thing, then that'd be very good. I'm going to leave this in here though, because, you know, the sheep are going to require it and the cows could have it as well. So there's no point trying to squeeze it into a silage pit. We'll have plenty of silage as it is. So yeah, back in the barn, and yeah, then we're going to have to go and get the, well actually I think we'll probably use, what should we use? We don't need a very big machine to do this, but I want something a bit nippy, because I like to get to and from the store quite quickly, as we do the trip so often. I suppose the quad bike, but I don't think it fits to it, from what I can remember. Right, okay, there we go. Yeah, the compact tractor would have been perfect, but it only does 9 miles per hour. I might still do it though. Oh! The gates are open. How have the cows not escaped? The other one's open too. You fool, Daggerwind, you've left the gates open. There we go. That is much better. Okay, right, let's just go and find a different tractor then. And there's the water boundary over there. I've used a telehandler in the past, and it has actually worked quite well. In fact, I think I might do. It's not a bad machine to use, because it's got gears and everything. What a mess. All those bales. I'll also take the spike off, because we don't need it. I'll just put this over here. And then I've got the challenge of trying to reverse this dolly trailer. There we go. It's fine for a short time, but then you totally mess up. Right, so off to the store. Actually, we should probably check the price first of all. It should be a miscellaneous. I think it is. £7,000, and what do we get for this one? I will find out when we get there, because obviously there'll be a bonus on top, so we don't need to be guessing. And we probably should take the quad bike out of the reset point, because it doesn't look very good. Right then, so here we are. I'll have to put it in the sell box. And it's not going to be worth much. It's a vintage machine anyway. I think it's made of wood. It pretty much is made of wood. So I suppose it might have been a better idea to keep it and buy another one, but then we don't really have the money for that. Oh, yes, £1,200. Fantastic. So yeah, we're going to be dangerously low with money, but I'm just thinking, we are obviously going to sell this silage, and it's going to be worth probably £300,000, I'd have thought, maybe even more. So we're not going to be doing too badly for money at the end of this, so I'm not really worried, but I am worried about that. Oh, crikey, it doesn't fit. We're going to have to go and get a different machine after all of this. What a lot of faffing about. Well, instead, I'm going to use the Massey Ferguson 7718, because we do need to refuel this anyway. It's reminding me to do it. This could be expensive, but nothing like refueling a combine. It's also a bit dirty as well. Hopefully it's going to rain soon, because that washes everything. Yes, Monday. Monday is the washing day. Every machine will be cleaned. Actually, we don't need to fill this. We'll probably do half a tank. I should do. Because we are getting low on money, like I say, but it's not going to be a long-term thing. Just short-term. Right, so hopefully this will fit to it. It's a fairly universal fitting. I'm surprised it didn't fit to the telehandler. Right, so finally, let's take this back to the yard. This is a bigger Bowser, but it's still not that big. There is the modified one of the slurry tanker, which has obviously got a very large capacity. But this should do, as we're not even going too far between the two yards. And there might even be a refill point at the pig farm. Okay, so here we go. Oh, another expense. This is going to cost money. Yeah, I'm surprised that water is so expensive in this game. If you look at the money rocketing down, this is just tap water. That is more expensive than bottled water. Must be good stuff. What did that even cost us? That was a lot of money. Incredible. I would expect a water bill, but nothing quite as large as that. That was very expensive. I think it was about £1,000. I'd probably expect a bill of probably about £20 for that. For the amount of this, maybe 50. But oh well. We'll be getting a big cash increase very soon. Right, so this is the silo we have to fill up. Should just be a case of reversing up to it. Done this many times before, so it's nothing new. There it goes. And while we're here, we might even be able to buy some cattle as well. They're going to require some wheat and also some root crops as well, but that isn't totally essential right now. At least they've got some feed. So I don't know if this is actually going to work. It might not do. But we can give it a go. Yeah, super quick because we don't own any. That's why it was so quick. I think we'll probably buy about 10. Maybe 11. 12. Let's go for 12. Okay, we now officially have no money. As soon as it's fermented, we'll do a big selling session. I might do it off screen because we've done it before. And then we'll have so much money. But again, it's not going to be like stupid money. It's not going to be so much that we don't know what to do with it. It'll all be still used very quickly. It'll be reinvested into the farm. And we do need to buy a new combine as well. So, in fact, that'll probably eat away the entire profit there. I think, actually, while we're here, as I've still got 44% water left, I should probably give it to the cows because they're going to need it. They're just around here. Is there another floating egg? There is! There's another floating egg! Yay! Floating egg! I still don't understand why it's there. Strange oh, wow. A lot of eggs. Yeah, strange spawn point, I think. We should really be taking these to the sell point. Another floating egg there. Hello. And one here. So how many do we have? Wow, lots of withered fields. None of them are ours though. Chickens, right. We have 23 in our backpack. There are still 8 on the ground somewhere. There's one. Well, when we have a few more, we'll definitely take them to the sell point. Oh no. I keep bringing the notes up because R is the same button for a lot of things. It isn't the button for the gate, I just got very confused. Now where do you take this to? Just over here. I think you go on the far side. Yep. Filling it up very slowly, but it's all extra. There we go. And that is some of our animal work now done. Obviously, we still need to do the wheat for them. We also need to have some root crops as well. We don't actually have any root crops at the moment because I sold them. So it might not be a bad idea planting a field with something like sugar beet or potatoes because it's obviously going to be required. Now, this seems to be my Bowser storage point. I'm just going to put it back over here. We'll just park it up there. The next thing we need to do is sort all this out. I don't think we can tow that trailer though. So I'm just going to have to put it back in the workshop over here. I tend to just reverse it next to the compressor. There we go. And yeah, I'm going to need to get a tractor to move the chrome trailer, and there is also a front weight there as well. Quite a big one. It's 700 kilos, so yeah, it's going to need quite a big tractor. This tractor here looks pretty good. And then I think, really, that is everything I wanted to do today. So, I'm just thinking, is there another field that needs to be harvested? Because I don't want to do any more harvesting with that combine. Not because it's a bad combine, it's just I want to change it and obviously use a bigger one. Especially this sunflower field here. This is one massive field. And using that small class mega combine would take forever. Well, it's quite fun when you got tramlines because you can run in between all the crops. But it also does show how the crop destruction is working. It does seem to have quite a lot of weeds here, but I have put herbicide A on, so it probably could do with another dose. But the nutrients is pretty good, doing okay. So this does need to be harvested as soon as possible before all of those seeds fall out. But yes, let's just move this front weight and also the trailer. But these are such handy trailers, these, and we will be using them again because we do need to do another fruit harvest. Because, yeah, fully laden once again, this orchard is, and I should think the other one is as well, down at field number 17. Which took you around the back somewhere. We do also have that smaller monsoon sprayer. I think I might keep it though, because it's still very handy for the very tight fields. The self-propelled one is going to be our main sprayer, but it doesn't fit into every field we own. Right, okay, it can just go here. And I probably should think about getting a slurry spreader as well, because obviously, now we own the cows, we're going to start to produce this slurry. Slurry pit, toxic gas, no entry. Why would you want to enter it? Do not fall in, I'm guessing it's saying. It's totally empty though. Surprised, I would have thought we'd have some by now. Yeah, we do. Probably not enough though to register because it can get really full. And potatoes? No. Sugar beet, we don't have any. So it is a bit of a priority to get a root crop. There's our oat field that needs to be done as well. Actually, if we do one more field with that combine, it'll be that one because it's small. But I think that is actually it for today. And I know it's not a very long video once again, but that is everything I wanted to do. Oh, we should probably shut the gate. Otherwise, these cows are going to be escaping. But yeah, they're doing okay. Ah, yes, there is a Marshall spreader, very similar to this. And I think we should probably use it. But it's going to be for the smaller fields, because it's not got a very big working width. And it would take forever to do the big fields. But yep, they've got their water here, and I think they've got feed inside. So everything seems to be going pretty well. I think also, yeah, the milk does automatically sell. Even though you're supposed to have the stop milk sale mod installed, I haven't done because of other maps. That's looking pretty empty. How are they doing? They've got enough. They'll last. So I think, yeah, that is going to be it now until the silage is fermented, which shouldn't be too long at all. It's probably already started. Let's just take a look. 2%, wow. Well, yeah, hopefully it won't be too long. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. Thank you for watching, and hopefully you've enjoyed Thornton Farm this week. We will return for more episodes on this map next week. But until then, thank you for watching, and hope to see you again in the next video. Bye for now.